Hello everyone. Today we start with the artificial methods of vegetative propagation. Now in this artificial methods of vegetative propagation,
now the very first method of artificial method is the stem cutting. Now in stem cutting, it is the cutting with the leaf buds which is taken, and in this we see the diagram. This is the stem cutting. The cutting of a healthy young branch is taken, which is having the leaf buds on this. This is the leaf buds which are present, and these leaf buds are with the leaf buds. This stem is planted in the soil. The cutting develops the roots and it grows into a new plant. So this is very common in the rose, sugarcane, chamele and bougainvillea. Next we come to now second method of artificial vegetative propagation is layering. Layering is done is very common in jasmine. It is in the mint and in vine plants, in which the young branch of the stem, the plant which is very near to the soil, this is bent, it is touching the ground, and it is given an oblique cut, the part which is touching the ground. So it is covered with the moist soil and it forms a layer. So the roots are developed from the covered part from this cut, and the branch is cut. When it develops a healthy plant, this is given a cut and it grows into a new plant. So it is separated from the parent plant, so it grows into a new plant, and this is called as layering. Next of all we come to the grafting method. Grafting method is the one in which the cutting of the two plants are taken, one with the base and one with the buds. One with the buds, the cutting of the stem with the bud is called as scion, and the one which is having the rooted plant, the roots of the plant, the stem, this is called as the stalk. Now when this plant is taken, the two plants are taken, they are taken of the desired characteristics, and they are tied together, and they are, as they are tied together, with the nutritive material is given to them, they develop the vascular bundle connection in them and they form the roots. So as the vascular bundle connection is formed, this is taking up the characteristics and it gives out formation of the new plants with the second part in which the buds are present, which will develop into a healthy plant. So we are combining the characteristics of two plants, one with the healthy rooted system and the one of the flowers which we want. So this is very common in the hybridization techniques, as well as for the desired qualities of the plants in the wheat, in the rice, in the maize, for the one in which the grafting is done. Last of all we come to the tissue culture method, in which there is micropropagation. Micropropagation is the process of growing of new plants by the very few plants of the very few cells of the culture of the part which we want to take up. Now the plant in which the tissue culture technique is done, a very small part of the tissue is taken, that is called as a callus. And this explant is the part in which a small part of the tissue is taken, that is cut off from the growing part, tip of the plant, that is put into the nutritive medium in aseptic condition so that there is no contamination, and the cells grow rapidly and form a mass of cells. This mass of cells is formed as a callus. And then this callus is transferred into another nutrient medium, which is having the plant hormones, because we have to form the plant, so we have to give the hormones which will stimulate the formation of the stem and the roots. Yes, so the plant growth hormones are provided to it, the growth regulators, and the cells of the callus in this medium will divide and differentiate themselves into the root and the stem part, and they will form several plantlets. So these several plantlets which are formed, they are grown in the pots which are filled with soil, as they are taken up in orchids, in asparagus and in chrysanthemum. Next, now we come to economic importance of artificial that is propagation. Now this artificial propagation is very commonly used in horticulture and agriculture. This is very helpful in developing the high yielding varieties of fruits, very developful in developing the disease resistant varieties of the fruit trees. By this tissue culture, we can grow thousands of plants from a single tiny piece of a plant. Yes, so number of plants which are grown, they are free of infection. Now we talk about the advantages of vegetative propagation. The advantages is, the very first is rapid multiplication. Rapid multiplication is, this vegetative propagation is very rapid, easier, and it is a very cheap method of plant propagation. So the plants can bear fruits and the flowers very early. Then their genetically identical offsprings are formed. So exact copies of the new plants which are formed, they are total identical to the parent plant. they are very easy to grow because they need very less attention in the very early stages. And then the seeds which are formed, the multiplication is done without the seed formation, because we are not having the plants with the seeds over here. So the as banana, the seedless grapes, the rose, the pineapple, the dahlia, they do not produce the viable seeds and they can be grown with the vegetative propagation. Next, last of all, we come to the disadvantages of vegetative propagation. Now the plants which are formed, they are genetically identical plants, and as they are genetically identical, they are having more chances of getting infection with a sudden spread of diseases in the farm. And the last of all is overcrowding may result of such plants, because they are grown in the same area as there is no dispersal of the plants from the parent plant. So there is overcrowding and very less of growth of the plants we can have. Thank you so much.